It's been 9 days, almost to the minute, since baby Lisa Irwin was last seen by her mother.
Sometime in the night, she was snatched from her crib. No sign of her since. And tonight, we have the police dispatch tapes from that morning and the hours that followed. KMBC 9's Martin Augustine is live with the exclusive. Martin?
Well, Larry, what we hear in the tapes is how police dispatchers first interpret the initial call and how quickly the severity of the situation escalates. All of this starting at about 4 in the morning back on October 4th when Jeremy Irwin, Lisa Irwin's father, returns home to his Northland home that you see right back here after working an overnight shift.
10-7, residential burglary in progress, 3620 North Lister. Contact Jeremy, response code 1.
Respond code 1 means get there fast. Jeremy is Jeremy Irwin, Lisa's father, and the label of the call, a residential burglary, changes in a split second with Irwin's description of what he found.
He knows his screen is busted and his 10-month-old daughter is missing. He advised that he didn't witness anything and doesn't know how long she's been gone.
That call initiates the intense search for Lisa Irwin, and from that point, the radio calls between dispatchers and officers are calm, measured. You briefly hear officers talking about positioning themselves throughout the immediate area and talking to neighbors in what police call an area canvas.
How are you on your area canvas?
I'm finishing up with the neighbors from across the street. And I'll contact you here in a minute.
Call me back, Phil. ASAP.
Note how that officer says, call me on my cell phone. Listening to the tapes from those first 2 hours, you hear officers saying that, call me on my cell. That keeps them off of their radio, so we don't know what they're saying in those conversations.
Channel 9 has copies of the first 12 hours of police dispatch tapes, so we have a lot to go through to see how that first day really shaped up.